I've been working on fixing the TypeScript errors on my desktop app project. And so I've been migrating my source code from Flow.js to TypeScript, and I've got 2,500 TypeScript errors, and I've finished fixing them almost all, and now there are only 36 errors in 20 files. It was so hard to fix them. The app is not able to run at the moment because there are a bunch of breaking changes I made that are like bumping up the dependencies. And here is my memo, tech note I took while working on migrating the flow to TypeScript. So I've got a bunch of errors, and this one is about due to ES module, because Electron by default Electron does not support importing ES module. That's like Node.js, so you have to bundle ES modules to your app.js or like something like that, using Webpack. Yeah, so I consider make my internal modules ES module, but that's going to be too hard. So I decided to go with another way, that is using Webpack. And here are some errors I got when I tried to launch the app. And next up is the mobile app. So I've been also working on supporting the share extension to provide a way to share a link from other apps to Inkdrop. And I've got it to work. So last week I looked into an open source React Native project that is called Raindrop, and which has a share extension feature. And so I managed to get it to work on my project, as you can see here. So let me show you a demo. So this is an iOS simulator, and yeah, so you've got the app icon on the share sheet, and you can tap, and yeah, so this is a React Native instance, so you can build a UI and sharing a feature using React Native. And so I'd like to share how I did it. That was not so simple, because you have to extend your pod file, but first you have to follow the steps that is for usual iOS apps. And so here is a link. So here is the page I followed. Make a share extension from the Xcode and set up the new target and activate the scheme. Yeah, and the next step is to add another entry point for the React Native by doing so. Yeah, and the next step is to add a new target on pod file that is for the share extension. And I named the share extension, so I added a target to share extension scheme. Yeah. So your pod file will be something like this. It's kind of complicated. but yeah, you have to do it. And you have to add a hook, a post-install hook, that is to disable the application extension API only flag to make so that React Native gesture handler can be built for the shell extension. Yes. And the next step is to add to initialize your React Native instance in the shell extension by adding RCT bridge and module name and initial props and add a protocol. Implement a protocol of the RCT bridge delegate. Then implement the share view controller like so. That is that was easier than I thought. Yeah, so I'm glad it got it. So I'm glad I got it to work. Yeah, so that's it. Yeah, I'll keep working on it. So thank you for watching and have a productive day.